So, place number 16 on my list is The Sundering, Rise of the Witch King. It's a Warhammer-based mod. So the first Warhammer mod that ever released from Medieval Total War Kingdoms was Call of Warhammer, today known as Rage of the Dark Gods, because they were forced to change the name of the mod because Games Workshop, the company behind the Warhammer franchise, didn't like that the Russian modders behind Call of Warhammer, a mod from 2029, they didn't like that they used the name Call of Warhammer. They didn't want them to use Warhammer in their mod name. So the Russian developers, had to change the name to Rage of the Dark Gods. However, in 2012, a submod released of Call of Warhammer, a submod with completely different models that started as a submod of Call of Warhammer but ended up its own mod, so it has its own page on Total War Center and is also available on modb.com, so you can download it from modb, and it has its own thread on Total War Center, and it's available for download on modb.com, and it started as a submod, as I said, but became its own mod because it's different and it has completely different models and such. So this mod is taking place earlier than the main Call of Warhammer mod. It's set in the Elven Civil War during an event known as the Sundering, and you can play as a bunch of elves in the Grand Campaign. So the Grand Campaign, you have Daemons of Chaos, which is a rebel faction, I believe, and the Cultists, another rebel faction. So you have two factions that shouldn't be playable, but I made them playable, and that's the Cultists, which is religious fanatics, later to become Dark Elves, and then there is the Daemons of Chaos, a bunch of demonic beings that spawn like the rebels in different locations on the map. So you play in this area only Ulduan, actually, the Elven homeland, the High Elven homeland. During the time of the Sundering, the Dark Elves didn't exist, and they were still High Elves. And their faction, Nagarit, led by, I believe, Malekith, that faction was still based in Ulduan, the Elven homeland, together with others. So there are a bunch of different Elven factions here. We have Kreis over here, starting with this area. And we have Kotik, this area. So this is pretty much an Elven civil war, the Sundering. We have Eatain, we have Anar, they weren't probably supposed to be played as, but they're a small faction over here. I've made everyone playable on the map. We have Safre, another area, over there, they hold, and we have Yvres, this area. We have Nagarite, the forebearers of the Dark Elves. You will have a young version of Morati if you play as them. And I believe also Malekith might be a part of this faction, but at least I know that Morati is a part of it. This is a time before they became Dark Elves. So the symbol looks like a Dark Elven symbol, but here they named Nagarite instead of Dark Elves. Then we have Tomb Kings. They weren't a part of the original game. I believe I installed a sub-mod that added the Tomb Kings, because this mod in the campaign had the Cultists and the Daemons of Chaos as spawning factions that you fight. And then it had a bunch of Elven factions that can fight each other, because the Sundering is all about the Elven Civil War. And then in Custom Battle it had a bunch of other factions like the Tomb Kings, the Skaven, the Orcs and Goblins, the Dwarves, Rakeland, which is an Empire faction, and then they had one or two units from Tilia or Estalia as well, and the Wood Elves, and maybe they had something else too. And there were a guy over at Total War Center that released a submod for it, which added the Tomb Kings to the map, which is only Ultan still, and yeah, I believe that's it. We have Illyrian, Avalorn, and Kalidor as well. I once played an Avalorn campaign back in 2012. I didn't speak back then, but this mod is for you if you if you like Warhammer, and if you want to play the events of the Sundering, the Elven Civil War. I believe Malekith was the rightful ruler of Ultuan, but he was cruel, and other elves didn't want him as their leader, so civil war broke out, and it ended with Nagarit leaving Ultuan and becoming the Dark Elves and such. I don't know everything in detail, I'm no Warhammer expert, but that's about it, and I play this game at least for a few episodes on my YouTube channel back in 2012, until I believe my computer broke down and I had to get a new one. Then I didn't continue for some reason, but there were some unfortunate events back during the spring of 2012, so I believe those events interfered with me picking up this mod again. I believe I played it in 2013 as well as a different faction, but I played Avalorn in 2012 on my YouTube channel without speaking, but then you didn't speak when you played. But when it comes to the 2013, I believe I played a different faction. No, I played as everyone, probably in a hot seat campaign, and just had some fun, but I never finished the campaign in this. What I can say is that it has completely unique models on the map and in battle, and they are not the same models as in Call of Warhammer. So in Call of Warhammer they used models from the official game, I believe Mark of Chaos, and they made their own models. But in this mod they actually got permission to use official models from the game Warhammer Online, so it's using models straight from Warhammer Online, but I believe the modders have probably picked the gear and you know, the details like shoulder pads, weapons, and shields and such, and probably reskin them too a bit, but they are models from Warhammer Online, used with Games Workshop's permission. Okay, let's start the game as Nagarite, just to show off the map. These models have unique loading screens. I believe they are from Warhammer Online. I've seen this scene in the trailer for Warhammer Online before. So this mod, unlike Call of Warhammer, is only about Elven Civil War, but if you play custom battles you can play as other factions as well, and they also have models from the Warhammer Online game. In this mod certain strat models are not custom, so for example this assassin is still a vanilla assassin, the spy is still vanilla, but generals and soldiers are custom, and I believe that the priests of some factions are custom, and then they have custom princesses that look really good. The princess models in this mod are really good looking. I used them in Warcraft Total War in the demo because they were so good, but that was before we made our own models. Of course they were replaced by Warcraft models later. Okay, but I used them in the demo, I believe, before we had our own models. Okay, Tugilfau, so we can see that this mod is still a pretty decent sized mod. It's not the biggest mod, it only has Ultan after all. It has about 12 factions or so. Check diplomacy, you can see that there are alliances in this game. Everyone is not at war with each other, there are some allies and such. In ordinary Call of Warhammer, I believe everyone starts neutral with each other or at war with each other. No one is allied to anyone, with the exception of probably the Empire factions, they are allied to each other. But in this mod we have different alliances based on lore at the start. And this mod was also the first Warhammer mod that had reskinned elven cities. So the skins of high elven cities, they come from this mod. The high elven skins. So cities in this mod are vanilla, but they have unique skins. As an example, I remade the skins from this mod and from Call of Warhammer, because Call of Warhammer used the same skins in later versions. I believe Beginning of the End Times used some of the skins from this mod, and I believe we used the ones from Beginning of the End Times, but the original this mod was first with using unique skins for the walls and the buildings of vanilla settlements, and I believe in Warcraft Total War that we remade them into Warcraft skins. But anyway, I think this is a pretty cool mod because it has completely unique models, a new map as usual, and then it has events and scripts and such. It's not the most finished mod. As you see, certain strat models are not Warhammer but vanilla. But there are also some Warhammer ones, like this Priest of Assyrian here, or the Gothic Diplomat, totally custom. We have the Princess model, really good looking. All the elven factions have princess models, but they have different colors. Okay, and as I said, the cities in battle are impressive with the skins, but there are no custom settlements. This mod also has dragons and eagles and other creatures that make it different from Call of Warhammer. I believe recent versions of Call of Warhammer, like Beginning of the End Times and the Alternative Cut, they have even more impressive animations and units. But back in 2012, when this mod released, Call of Warhammer didn't have Hydras, didn't have Manticores, didn't have Griffins, and didn't have Giant Dragons. And this mod was the first mod that added such creatures to a Warhammer mod. It added flying creatures, I mean. And the animations for them are pretty much outdated by today's standard, but for 2012 it was impressive. And I highly recommend this mod, even if I think it's unfinished and could use work. I know that the developers have long since abandoned the mod, but I am thinking about maybe releasing an official sub-mod where I add at least strat models to replace these vanilla strat models, because this mod has a bunch of outdated vanilla models, like this spy here. And I know today how to make a strat model from out of a battle model. So for example, I could take one of these models and make a strat model out of it. And so if I find a suitable model for a spy, I could turn the suitable battle model into a spy on the map, and then I could release a submod over Total War Center where I have replaced all these vanilla models with actual Warhammer models. But that's just something I have thought about. But even with the old outdated models and maybe an incomplete campaign where not every script was finished and such, I still think this mod is worth a try for anyone who likes fantasy mods for Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms. Anyone who likes Medieval 2 and fantasy should try this mod. I would say that this mod was more impressive than the original Call of Warhammer, and maybe all the Call of Warhammer releases up to maybe 2012. Of course, Call of Warhammer was more impressive in terms of size. It had a larger map, and it had more factions and such. But this mod had more creatures, more flying creatures and such, and Hydras and such. So I always thought this one was more impressive, while Call of Warhammer had more like ordinary stuff, like it had more like humanoid characters, infantry, cavalry, that stuff, and mages, but it didn't have flying creatures and giant monsters. Okay, of course later versions of Call of Warhammer has that, but not back then. This mod was more impressive in that regard. Okay, so this is on place 16 on my list, because I think it's more impressive than the previous mod, because it has custom models, and the models of this mod for the elves and then any other faction that is in custom battle, I think the models here are more impressive than the models of Call of Warhammer. For the most part, there might be some exceptions. Let's start a quick battle. Because these models are from Warhammer Online, and those models just they are better. They are more aesthetically pleasing, in my opinion. Yeah, the Dark Elves especially look better here. Here we have a veteran spearman unit of Eltinarvan. No, this is not the Dark Elves, this is the Nagarite faction. It's the faction before they became Dark Elves. I believe the Dark Elves are available in custom battle. We have the Hydras here. So this was the first mod that had the Hydras in a Warhammer setting. Of course, the Hydras in beginning of the end times are even more impressive, because they have unique animations for their heads and such. In this mod, they are just elephants with a Hydra model. But back in 2012, Call of Warhammer didn't have any Hydras, so this mod was the only one with Hydras, and it was very impressive. Even today, I think this mod is impressive, and that the ordinary models often look better. They have a more grim look to them. They look more artistic, in my opinion. More interesting. But, of course, the animations of all the creatures, like the Hydras and the Dragons and the Manticores and the Griffins, they are outdated by today's standards. And as such, this mod could use an updated, animations file. The animations from Call of Warhammer Beginning of the End Times are clearly superior, but it's not as easy as just moving over the animations. You need to rig the models on those animations too, and that's not done. I don't think anyone will do it either. I don't have the skills for that. Let's check the other faction. So we have Storm Vermin. We have the Skaven here. So the Skaven faction in this mod is also very impressive. Different looking. Now they spawned more troops. So they look different from in the other mod. And in my opinion, the models look more... should I say, more evil. Even have unique siege engines in this mod that are not the same as in Call of Warhammer. But I'm a bit disappointed that we didn't find any rat ogres in this army, but I believe they have that too, they just didn't spawn. Here we have some ordinary rats, but the models here have a more interesting art style and look more grim and evil, in my opinion, than in Call of Warhammer, where they look less cool. In Custom Battle, we have all of these factions. We have the Dwarves, we have the High Elves. High Elves is pretty much most of the units in one faction, but far from all of them. Because if you check the faction, faction of Kreis, for example, they have most of the units are the same, but then each faction has unique units. Like Kreis, for example, has the Kreisan Lion Chariots, or the Warriors of Blackwood, or the White Lion Pack, which is an animal handler unit. They also have the White Lions of Kreis. Then if you check, for example, Kotick, they have Shore Riders and Sailors of Kotick and Sea Rangers and Meravan's Mariners. So all the Elven factions have unique models, but then they share the basic and medium stuff. And if we play the High Elves, we have most of them in one faction, but there are still not everyone present in this pack here. I believe one or so from each of the minor factions, probably the exception of Nagarite, probably, and so maybe the other one, Alit Anar's faction, is not present there. Then we have the Dark Elves, my favorite faction in Warhammer. You see that they have Manticores, Cold One Chariots, Call of Knights, Cauldron of Blood, Vigils of Cain, Hydras, Harpies. Really good looking sorcerers, the best one I've seen in any Warhammer mod. Okay, and this was the only mod with creatures like the Manticores until recent releases of Beginning of the End Times. We have Tomb Kings, we have Kalador, that's an Elven faction, Tyrannok is an Elven faction too. We have Avalorn, Lyrion, Skaven, Orcs and Goblins. Check Orcs and Goblins and the Skaven and the Tomb Kings. See that we have an entire roster for the Orcs and Goblins with completely unique models. And an entire roster for the Skaven, including Rat Ogres. An entire roster for the Tomb Kings. I also believe that Rakeland, one of the Empire factions, also has an entire roster. Then we have the Wood Elves and Tilly, I believe. But they do not have entire rosters. They have like one or two units. I believe the Britannia faction also has one or two units. But they are not available here unless you edit a file and make them available. But Rakeland and I believe Rakeland at least has a full army. But is unfortunately not available here right now. With this said, this mod is recommended for anyone who likes fantasy mods and likes medieval 2, and I would say had some impressive models and creatures back in 2012 when Call of Warhammer, made by a Russian team, didn't have Hydras and Manticores and Griffins and such. Also, I believe Kalador is the Elven faction, the High Elven faction that has dragons. So if you like dragons, you can play as Kalador. They have really good dragons, but the models for them are not impressive by today's standard. And the Dark Elves, they didn't have any dragons in this mod. But the Kalador High Elven faction do have dragons. Okay, thanks for watching, and this is number 16 on my list. I've spoken a bit too long. Let's continue. Number 15 on my top 20 list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms for fantasy mods. Okay, Call of Warhammer, also known as Rage of the Dark Gods, Battle for the Empire, version 1.6. This particular version, I believe, released in 2012, if I'm not mistaken. It's a mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms, set in the Warhammer franchise, and it's made by Russian modders. Call of Warhammer, the first Warhammer mod ever for Medieval Total War, released in 29 by the same Russian modders. And this is version 1.6, the latest release. I believe it's from 2012. And I never played this version back in the day. I played the old versions all the way up to 2012, I believe, but I never managed to get a hold of 1.6. It was troublesome to get this one to work. I believe the translations didn't arrive until later. I didn't want to play a Russian mod, you know. I played the older version, the 1.5.5 or something. The 1.55 or something version. That's the one I played. This one had some new factions compared to the older one, and probably a more stable campaign and fixing of certain bugs and such. So let's go to the campaign, Storm of Chaos, the campaign. In this mod we have a lot of factions. We have this map, it's the same map as in all the Call of Warhammer releases from 29 until 2012. Never had more than the old world. It had the old world and nothing else. However, they did add certain factions to the old world, like the High Elves here. The Dark Elves start over here, so they pretty much added the Elves to the old world, because they didn't have the Elven homelands on the maps. Instead they were expeditionary forces in the old world. This mod is the original, and 1.6 is the latest version of the original. This is a translated version into English, but some text might still be English, I mean Russian. So it's an English version, but some text might still be Russian. We have a bunch of different factions. I don't dare clicking on everyone. I don't know if it's stable if I do that, but we have Warriors of Khorne, we have Minions of Saints, we have Children of Nurgle, and we have the Children of, the Cultists of Slaanesh. So all the Chaos factions are their own factions. So they are four different factions that fight each other and fight others. But then, when you have conquered the other Chaos factions as one of them, you can then you can get the option to form Chaos Undivided. So you can get the option during the campaign to form the Chaos Undivided faction, where you will get all the units from all four factions. And if you play a different faction, like the Empire for example, then the AI will spawn troops, and yeah, the Chaos factions will form the Chaos Undivided faction at one point in the campaign. Also, the Orcs and Goblins have their own invasions through spawns. This is a heavily scripted campaign, the original Call of Warhammer mod. So there are locked alliances between those factions that should be allied. You cannot ally certain factions. If you play as the Dark Elves, you can't. You cannot ally the humans, for example, the Empire. It's very much scripted who you are allied to and who you are at war with. So if you start allied with someone, that alliance will probably be during the entire campaign. Even though I think you can break an alliance and start a war with anyone, but you cannot ally anyone. You don't have the option to send diplomats. You can't click on certain factions to send diplomats there. I believe there is a forced alliance script in this mod that will enforce alliances each turn. I might be wrong, but I think this mod has a forced alliance script, so you can't stay at war with factions that you should be allied to for more than one turn. And also, I believe that you cannot click on your enemies with a diplomat, but the AI can of course click on you, but I don't think everyone has diplomats either. So in this mod you're expected to play it like in lore. It follows the Storm of Chaos events, and yeah, you will, if you play as a good faction, you will face Orc and Goblin invasions and Chaos invasions, and it's heavily scripted. In the older versions I had problems with CTD after about 42 turns in, but I don't know about this version. It might be more stable than the older ones. I used to play as the Dark Elves. I like this mod. I played as the Dark Elves until I couldn't play anymore at about turn 42. Then I played as everyone in Hot Seat campaigns during 2012 and earlier. And I didn't play this version exactly, but older versions. The difference with this one was that it added some new factions. So we had the Chaos factions, we have the Chaos Dwarves, we have the Dark Elves, we have the Sylvania Undead Vampire faction, we have the Night Goblins, the Orcs and Goblins, and we have the Grand Principality of Raiklands. All the Empire factions are represented as their own factions here. We have the Grand Duchy of Wissenland, the Grand County of Averland, the Grand County of Stirland, and the Grand Duchy of Middenland and Middenheim, and the Grand Duchy of Talabekland, the Grand Principality of Ostland, the League of Ostermark, and we have the Grand Duchy of Hochland, the Grand Barony of Nordland, we have the High Elves Expedition, Kars Anchor, the Dwarves, and we have Kislev, and we have the Border Prince Confederacy. And then we have the new factions. I believe this is the Tomb Kings, but they have the Russian name here. We have the Norse, they are their own faction in this mod, and we have the Skaven. And I believe in 1.6 that the Norse and the Tomb, the Norse and the Skaven were the new factions in this version. The Tomb Kings were added in an earlier version, I believe. But hadn't been in Bod for long. I believe they were in a prior version, but not the ones prior to that one. Okay, and I usually play as either everyone or as Sylvania or the Dark Elves. Let's take a look at the map. So this is the original Call of Warhammer mod. It is using the intro videos from the Mark of Chaos official games, at least for the Dark Elves. Okay. So, beginning of the end times is a sub-mod of this mod. So I believe English and English-speaking developers made their own sub-mod of this mod, and that became beginning of the end times. So this was the original mod by Russian modders, and it's still a very impressive mod and very good, but it's heavily scripted, and I believe the developers of beginning of the end times wanted a less scripted campaign, and I prefer that as well. But this one was the only option from 29 and until 2012, I believe, when the Sundering arrived. And it was still the only option if you wanted the old world. There were no other mod where you could play with the Elven homeland except the Sundering, which only had Ultan. Enabling assassins in CV, we have the option to enable that, and then we have some scripts here and events. I believe a welcome message. So there is some loading here. You need to click away. Little bit laggy here at the start of the campaign. Oh, now it's gone. Good. Okay, toggle foe. So you can see that the map is just the old world. But, you know that already. We have it packed with different factions too. And this was the Warhammer mod, the Call of Warhammer mod, before the arrival of beginning of the end times. Even with the Sundering, this continued to be the most popular Warhammer mod, because it had more factions and a bigger portion of the world playable. And most people prefer to play as different factions, like the Empire, the Orcs and Goblins, the Dwarves, the Chaos factions, the Elves, instead of just playing as the Elves. So that's why this was the most popular mod until the beginning of the End Times game, in terms of Warhammer mods, of course. You can say that the beginning of the End Times is like a sub-mod of this mod, that is bigger in scale and better in every way, pretty much. But there is one area where this one shines, and that's the scripted area. This has way more scripts, so if you want a heavily scripted campaign that is lore accurate, then this mod is more true to what you want. I highly recommend this mod. I played it for years, between 29 and 2012. I played this Third Age, and I believe, yeah, it was mostly this mod and Third Age that I played back then, because most other mods didn't exist. I believe Herul only had a custom battle demo in, or beta in 2011, and in 2012 they released the first version with a campaign, but it was horribly incomplete. This version, so this mod and Third Age were pretty much the fantasy mods back then. And it's still an impressive mod, and this version 1.6 is probably better than the one I played back then. So it has all the rosters from beginning of the end times, like the same rosters for the... It has, what I mean is, it has the original rosters, so it has the same factions and the same rosters, but the beginning of the end times submod added a lot more to it. It added more factions and more units, but the ones that are in this mod have about the same models. So for example, they look very similar. So if you like the beginning of the end times models, you will like this mod too. But this mod is recommended only if you like a heavily scripted campaign. Otherwise I recommend the other mod, and this mod is 16th mod on my list because it's still the original Warhammer mod and it has a huge number of custom models and skin cities and custom strat map models for both the characters, the agents and the city models in many cases. And not every settlement on a map is custom, but many are. It has custom boats and custom voices for their characters and custom music and everything you could expect from a great fancy mod. And where this mod shines compared to other Warhammer mods is that it is heavily scripted and follows lore more accurately. Most factions started war, but I believe the Empire and the Elves and the Dwarves and Kislev, they are allied, while other factions are mostly at war with each other. Okay, but the reason this is not higher on the list is because it's, I believe the older versions that I played were unstable. I couldn't play past turn 42. I don't know if this version is more stable. I haven't played it, you know. I downloaded it and took a look at it, but I never played it. So I will have to base the review on the version I played, and my opinion is that it wasn't very stable, and I disliked that the Beastman script that spawned the Beastman all the time. So it didn't matter how many times you killed them off, they came back all the time. That's lore accurate, but very annoying. I like killing off my enemies in Total War. I don't like when they respawn. And also it's a difficult mod when the Chaos factions will spawn huge stacks against you if you place the Empire, or if you place anyone else, and the Orcs and Goblins will also spawn huge stacks. And you couldn't ally anyone you wanted because that was scripted. So this is more for those that want a lore accurate scripted campaign, and I can't rank it higher than place 16 because of the all the scripts and the forced alliances and such. I think other mods that allow more freedom deserve a higher position on my list, because I have to rank them based on what I enjoy playing, and a heavily scripted campaign is not really what I enjoy playing. But back when this mod was the only option, together with the Sundering, I actually had no choice but to play this one. But now at the beginning of the End Times, I would never play this one over the beginning of the End Times mod. But this is the original, and it's still the 16th best fantasy mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms in my book in 2021. Okay, we can also quickly go to the custom battle screen, and you can see that it doesn't have as many factions as beginning of the End Times, but it has similar rosters. You can see that the units here are the same, but that the beginning of the End Times mod has increased the number of units a lot. So this mod is very similar. If you check the Dark Elves, you can see that it has the same units but as beginning of the End Times, but that in beginning of the End Times they have added many more rows of units. Okay, so this is the original Call of Warhammer, and it's the 16th best fantasy mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms in my book. Next one.